I'm Jim Sayers from Corn Belt Power Cooperative. I'm here today with Roger Hammond from Midland Power Co-op. And we're here by a house, I think, with an air source heat pump.
Yeah, this is an air source heat pump, Jim. This is a good alternative to a geothermal system. What an air source heat pump does is it has the ability to cool your home just like a regular central air conditioning system. That's why it looks like an air conditioning condenser here. But on the back side of it, it also has the ability to heat your home as well. So it's actually utilizing air from the outside temperatures, running it through a condenser. It has the ability to heat your home until the temperatures get down to about 20 degrees outside. Then you'll have a backup system such as a gas furnace that will be a supplemental heating system to this. Very economical system. They basically run at about 250 to 300% efficient, which basically means for every penny you spend to operate, it's going to give you 2.5 to 3 cents worth of energy back. One of the big advantages of this is for people that want to go into a heat pump system but maybe don't have the capital or the room on their site for a loop field to go into geothermal. This makes for a great alternative to a geothermal system. Basically, again, it has the ability to heat your home as well as do 100% of your cooling. So doesn't take up much room. It looks just like a regular air conditioning condenser out here. So it's a wonderful, wonderful system to put in your home for heating and cooling.
And this is all electric, so it would have advantages of that as well.
Yes, this is an all-electric system. Basically, other than the backside supplemental heat, you can put an electric furnace in to back this thing up, or you can put in a gas furnace. Many of your Touchstone Energy cooperatives offer reduced heating and cooling rates, so it would be very smart to check with your utility and see what they offer for a rate structure for an air source heat pump.